We're at the Black Lives Matter process in Brussels, just at the beginning of our project Reopening, which is about how borders and identity have changed because of COVID and what kind of future we want to have in Europe. And we think it's really, really important to be here to support Black Lives Matter, to support the fight against racism and systemic violence. And we're very interested as well by the borders of people's identity.
Bah, je pense que là, c'est le moment de les réouvrir parce que ça n'a aucun intérêt de les laisser fermer. Et je pense que c'est essentiel pour qu'on puisse respirer justement. Comme on dirait dans le slogan, mais c'est important. Ouais.
Half Indian, half English, and you're not even supposed to say half anymore. But I live in Brussels. Like, for me, it's always really difficult to say where you're from or what you're supposed to do. So I always like to say I'm a man of the world. Because, you know, even just before the Second World War, all across Europe, all of the borders were reimagined and they just created so much weird shit that didn't need to be there.
Les frontières, c'est plutôt dans nos têtes qu'on se les met en fait. Voilà. Les frontières, c'est parce qu'on se les met dans nos têtes, ce qui fait que justement, certaines personnes justement n'arrivent pas en fait à respecter la différence. Quand on dit Black Lives Matter, ça devrait être aussi World Lives Matter, c'est des problèmes du monde en fait, quoi. Tu vois ? Et je pense que c'est important qu'on soit là tous pour qu'on puisse se rappeler que, quelles que soient les couleurs qui existent, noir, jaune, blanc, on est tous les mêmes. Et il faudrait que le peuple entier comprenne qu'on pourrait être tous ensemble. Il faudrait justement qu'on arrête à certaines personnes, à des politiciens, à d'autres personnes, de nous diviser, parce que justement, en nous divisant, ils mettent en place des frontières, tu vois. Voilà comment je vois la chose.
Like I'm Brazilian, so it's harder to me to pass for some border than some European people. That makes no sense. Their identity defines where you can go, what you can do. And a border is just something that the human being created to separate people, because we are all people, and makes no sense to put limits to we walk in this world. It should belong to everyone.
Talking about borders and confinement, it's like the space. I think we were more in a defined space, and we had more the perception of this border, of this space, even things that we can do, we cannot do, the distance that we can go or we cannot go.
It's a very strange feeling. You suddenly do feel confined. The borders are suddenly not just country borders, but also the borders of your house. What borders are allowed? Are we allowed in someone else's house? Is outside a border. It's a very strange new concept.
For me, as a black person, I'm quite aware that there is a border between my blackness and my whiteness, and since like the things that I do to be accepted in a predominantly white society, and the things which make me black are like separate borders, sometimes very opposites, but I have to negotiate all the time. And I'm saying this because I just get back from the Black Lives Matter, so that's predominantly in my mind at the moment. You know, as a gay man as well, it's not very easy as well to you know, like try to film yourself, but at the same time say like, you know, acceptable. I know that people say like you can be yourself, but when you are at this crossing of black men and gay men, sometimes like to negotiate the world outside can be quite difficult. And that's created a certain border in you where you kind of compartmentalize between things and always conscious of how people are going to see what you're doing, basically.